Vice President-elect Duterte Carpio set to meet with outgoing Education Secretary Leonor Briones next week for their plans for the agency. Duterte says this will be their first face-to-face meeting since she accepted the post as the next education chief. She adds President-elect Marcos Jr. already gave his instructions to review the implementation of the K-12 program.
Nakailang exchange of communications na kami, written communications na kami ni Secretary Briones, and the initial face-to-face, the very first face-to-face meeting will be on June 25. But before that, meron na kaming mga arrangements na nagawa. Titingnan natin paano natin mapush yun from kung ano yung mga accomplishments galing sa administration ni PRB.
Doris Fernandez Ferrer, the executive director of the Private Education Assistance Committee, says Vice President-elect Duterte has shown she has a good grasp of the education sector's concerns. Ferrer adds they also received positive feedbacks from Duterte from education institutions in Davao.
When we listen to the feedback coming from educational institutions in Davao City, they're saying that she actually values efficiency, which is something that we welcome in the private education sector. She's very hardworking and she has the political will to solve the challenges in the education sector.
Ferrer also floated the idea that the vice president-elect come up with a framework for both private and public schools, noting this framework should help both school systems to work together.
As education secretary for both public and private schools, then she will have to make sense of the needs of both and at the same time come up with the overarching framework and roadmap. We need a roadmap that will actually give all of us the direction as to how we will proceed as partners of the public school system or of the DepEd schools. Kasi pag walang maayos na framework yan, sadly, because private schools actually depend a lot on tuition and other fees, there are some government policies that hurt the private schools. Case in point, the salaries of public school teachers.
For House lawmaker Joey Salceda, one of the ways Vice President-elect Duterte Carpio can improve the academic performance of Filipino students is by tackling nutrition. Salceda says this can be done by closely working with local government units. The House Ways and Means Committee chairperson, meanwhile, doesn't see any problems in terms of the Education Department's next budget.
Ang meron ni Sara na sa tingin ko na for the first time, DepEd now would have been in a better position to fight for budget. Unlike before na hindi Vice Presidente ang sekretary ng DepEd, ngayon dahil Vice Presidente siya with 32.2 million votes, with the highest majority since Magsaysay, then I think she would have the mandate as well as of course the access to resources to fight for the needed resources in order to make DepEd more competitive and do its national mandate.
The incoming Marcos administration will have more assets to defend the country's territory. Outgoing Defense Secretary Delphine Lorenzana says under the Duterte administration, government has acquired two missile frigates, the BRP Jose Rizal and the BRP Antonio Luna. The military also gained more firepower with 16 units of Black Hawk helicopters and 6 units of A-29B support aircraft. Lorenzana adds, aside from boosting the defense system, the new assets also improve the country's humanitarian assistance and disaster response. Lorenzana will formally step down on June 30th and will be replaced by the next DND chief, retired General Jose Faustino Jr. Not a single square inch of territory will be surrendered. That is the marching order of President-elect Marcos to his defense chief designate, Jose Faustino Jr. Faustino vows to protect and defend the country's sovereignty with respect to human rights and international law. Also on his agenda are addressing climate change, terrorism and criminality, as well as continue the momentum of the campaign in ending the local communist armed conflict. The continued modernization of the armed forces is also a top priority of the incoming chief of the Defense Department.